now arriving at Yijang Tower. Initiating match.
Score.
ready for battle.
Close your eyes.
Put them in the ground.
Ready for battle.
Victory! That is definitely a highlight for SUNY Potsdam for tonight.
I do think, though, that changing their supports was the play.
Yes, it definitely was. It definitely was. So now, correct me if I'm wrong here. So now we go to a different game mode. Now, is that banned? Is that, like, pick banned?
They've already figured it all out ahead of time. But yeah, so the winner bans, or no, the loser bans, and then we pick. So Oswego banned their map, and then... Anyways, through the leagues that we played last semester, it was the loser gets to ban a map they don't want to play, and the winner gets to pick the map. And then,
okay.
Okay, so I was wrong. There's no bans going forward. It's the loser gets to pick the map, and winner chooses what side they wish to start on, whether that's attack or defense. So we're going into Eichenwald is our next map. A hybrid map where you start off by capturing a point, much like what we just watched. However, once that capture point is unlocked, you then proceed to escort this payload through a slew of twists and turns until it gets to the end, or till the opposing team, the defendant team, stops it. So we'll see going forward if this looks like a win.
Yeah, I don't know. He kind of giving off a little bit of bad vibes right now. I don't know about you. Mods, can we kick this guy? Can we kick off this Dasko Larry guy? Kind of need to. Yeah, I don't know about this guy.
Dude, I love Rocket League. Alright, sweet. Now, welcome back, guys. We're streaming Overwatch 2 now instead of Rocket League. We may or may not have gaslit you, but it's A-okay. You know, what is with life if you can't have a little bit of gaslighting, you know?
That's one thing you
can say. Yeah, we got our lovely couch over here giggling back here.
We've got a whole army in the stream.
Yeah,
right
dude,
now.
We were arguing this. So if there is, right, if you know the word thruple, right? So how would you say the next word? Is it thruple or quruple? Like quadruple. Like quadruple. You know? Like how would you pronounce that? Like I don't even know. But you know what? It's okay. We'll figure it out. We'll see what happens. You know, maybe next week we'll come up with an answer. You know, I don't know.
check in next week to find out the answer to the question everybody's looking for, right?
Dude, what the hell is with these? What? Dude, why can't I get a kiss? Where's my kiss? I mean, jeez, man. Scout in for Brockport this year. Crazy.
Okay, buddy, you're pronouncing my name. Also, just remember, this is on like a 2 or 3
like
minute delay.
Yeah. These guys are a little behind, but you know what? You know what? It's okay. You know what?
Okay, buddy.
Oh, I see. Now he just got it. Get him out of here.
Get him out of here.
Dude, I don't want to hear it, bro. I beat you in Rumble. It's okay. Like, it's okay. Like, you know, I did beat him in Rumble. Like, you know, I'm not even gonna say anything else about it. Because, you know what, I won, and you know what, if we're gonna have some butter people, it's okay. I don't even know how he got my Discord. Diasco Larry is telling me that I have to raise up the volume a little bit. But, like, I care about my viewers, you know? Like, I want to make sure that my viewers are fine. And,
your
you know,
viewers
like,
are our viewers.
Yeah, exactly.
For sure.
Right?
Yeah, for sure.
Exactly. Like, I want to make sure that we're all good here. You know, we're vibing. We're having a good time. And not, you know, having our ears bled because we're fucking through.
I mean,
we're
my
screaming.
Ears aren't bleeding yet, so I'm happy.
Well, yeah. Also gonna stream Valorant as well. If you can delay it as much as possible. Still?
Tom Brady, I don't know what games are being streamed tomorrow. That'll be up to whoever can be available to commentate. Right?
We're going to Eichenwald.
They're both good Rhyme maps. I wouldn't be surprised if we did see Battle Lose on Rhyme, but my guess is with the state of the game right now and Orisa being so strong, we're probably going to see Orisa. Although we did see Oscar go right there.
Ready for battle.
Mercy. The Bridge Mercy is going to be interesting. It's going to be really reliant on Halo staff to be able to hit their shots on this axe, right? God damn it.
Are we going
to see how this goes?
Five,
I will say,
four,
their
last three, two, one. Attackers incoming. Defend objective A.
Sie werden dich nicht kriegen.
Adaptive circuits engaged. Ash. Bob, do something. Adaptive circuits engaged. Junkrat.
Here it comes. Pflicht ist nicht getan.
Adaptive circuits engaged. Reaper.
To fight him, and the Mercy gets a free res. The Orisa is sitting there. I don't know how the Mercy gets away with it, but they do. And before Timepiece died on the Kiriko, he got his ult off, which made everything faster. So, like, the fact that they stayed in that fight was a combination of some great plays.
Ready for battle.
Hopefully that should fix it, make it a tiny bit better.
Okay, so we're going to see Victor again on this Echo. However, they swapped off the Ana onto the Moira. You can tell here.
We got a Pharah though now. We're running.
Pharah?
We're running double nades here.
I like this setup because they're on the Ana with the Reinhardt. And this Reinhardt against this Zarya is going to be devastating.
I think honestly the better play would be here since we're kind of going a tiny bit brawly and we want to use our burst to our advantage. I honestly think the Mercy should have swapped off to a Lucio.
I don't disagree, but they run the Pharah, so we want to have a game.
Yeah. Right? Makes sense.
Oh, that was going on. The game's a little laggy, but Ryan's going in here. Should be kept up pretty well by this Ana.
Now we're kind of just playing around the pillar here. We're gonna have to pick a side.
I'm worried about Timepiece though. Timepiece does go down to this issue that we've been having with the current map. Are they going to get the reds?
That's a big pick.
They're going to wait. And I like this plan. They're going to wait for Ana to get back because they have the advantage. Because Moira has to get back.
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna wait out for the match.
Here we go. Who's ult just got used? It's our Mercy. Which Mercy? And so Bata Ooze gets.
Look, but there's that Anti on that drive.
Yep. And now the Mercy.
Adaptive circuits engaged.
Ooh.
Ooh, but our Mercy is now down. And so now we're gonna have to start focusing somebody else. Oh, but we got a point. No,
they lose that right from the Mercy going down too early there. Mm-hmm.
I think there should have been a better form of communication between ult usage because they kind of just threw out ult after ult after ult trying to hold on to the point, but it seemed like the fight was kind of a little lost after a bit.
I don't know if I would have committed the name.
Mm-hmm, definitely not. I do agree.
I think being down one, it got a kill, but we already used Shadow.
Yeah.
Oh, look, there's our flank and jump grab. It's damaging. The Moira commits to try to kill him, but she has no faith. There's that Echo. That Echo is never formed inside.
Agon, Bogatovnosti.
Zarya ult. No amount of nade is going to help that.
Combo of them. They did use two ults.
Yeah, but they still have three. Also, three is about to come up, I thought.
Mercy, Mercy's 54. I guess you could say. If she gets in 53. I don't know. I'm a little nervous. This Junkrat Tire, we've seen him do big things with it. He needs to do big things with this one. We need to see at least two kills. Junkrat over the rooftops gets in.
And he takes out the Zarya. That's such a big hit.
Adaptive circuits engaged.
Moira is forced to fade away. This is great. And the Mercy kills the Mercy. Oh my god! This is awesome. This is great. This is great. And there's the pick on the Echo. No, that's it. This is our point. And now we're going to go for 2.5 minutes, I think, now. Just about 2.5 minutes. So here we go. Oh, 3 minutes.
I am payload. Stunned as to how he continues to get value on this Junkrat.
I mean, it's like if he takes any Junkrat map, or that's for him, or even not for him. Did he still make some money?
He gets that kill on that Zarya. Opens up that entire fight for them. We've never seen them tired. Need to kill that. Oh, they don't manage to get that kill on Bastion.
Alright, here we go. Going across the bend, it seems like Sunio Suigo is just giving up the bend and playing under the bridge.
I don't hate this though. This bridge isn't that high ground for the Echo to play on.
Yeah, it does make sense. But it doesn't matter because Drunk is just gonna go. Look at him. He's just taking the space regardless of wherever that Echo is. And he's hitting. He's hitting the nades. This is ridiculous. That's fine. Here comes. Oh, that was a huge rock. That was a huge rock.
I don't know if I like Nano and the Sigma. Mm-hmm. The Sigma doesn't get that much value from it. Their Ana's in trouble right now. Their Ana just went down.
Yeah. It's a little tough right now. It's a little bit of a skirmish, but we don't, you know. Oh, you better hide, girl. Great movement. We're out of there.
My worry here is I haven't really seen the Ashe get a lot of value. Mm-hmm.
I mean, maybe they're just playing it for the ult. You know, Bob is very
strong.
Oh,
they swapped over to the Illari.
Who?
Illari, the newest character I was just added.
Who is this?
She has good damage.
Do something!
Oh,
there's the buff.
Oh
my god, but Bob gets
the
second pick. That is such a big pick onto the tank, but now it's just Echo. Echo just to kind of hold it off with the healers, and they're just pushing. They have to keep three on point. They have to keep three, and then just hold, push.
By Oswego there.
Oh, and there it is. Oh, just contested with 1 minute left. 1.5 minutes. Ooh, there it is. That's a huge.
Superpops has no support here. This comes down to the Junkrat being able to get these kills here.
And there's the pick on the tank. Now it's just. Ooh. No, I don't know.
Lucio's coming back. I don't think they're fast enough.
No, he's not.
Look at the time.
Deine Pflicht ist nicht getan.
It was so close.
Yeah, no, so very close.
Such a close map. 1.37 meters. I'm gonna be honest, I don't think that the Illari swap was a good choice. I think that having that Ana would have been so much better there.
Play of the game.
Oh, we know what this is. This is a big Mario.
Damage, so much healing, and now what are you gonna do about it?
You know,
tough. Now it's
close game though.
Yeah, no, it's currently 1-1. And so now it's coming down to this last one, or is it out of five.
I think it's out of five.
Okay.
If I remember correctly.
To bring out the whole scoreboard. So as of right now, it is now tied 1-1 in this series. Don't know exactly what the next game mode is going to be.
The next one is Flashpoint.
Flashpoint.
So it's the new mode where it's kind of like King of the Hill, that like that first map we ran. The difference being instead of it being 1 point per map, is one big map with five different points scattered throughout it, and each team is going to fight over each of these points. First one to capture 3 points wins.
Okay.
So the map is the same map, but it's almost like you're playing on a different part, a different map each time, because each point is a very different setup.
Mm.
Especially on this one, I can't remember the name of the maps. I haven't remembered all of them yet. It's actually up at the top. It's Servasa. I'm not exactly gonna pretend I know how to pronounce that word, but this is gonna be interesting because it's still a very new mode and not a lot of people know how to play it. So we'll see what people come up with the comps here. My guess, we're gonna see almost identical compositions to what we did for the last one. I feel like both teams are very comfortable in the heroes that they've been playing. I think we're going to see that echo, because I think that echo is the reason that they won that last game.
Yeah, for sure. What does this do?
Brings up a whole...
An angle with that.
This is awesome.
Ready for battle.
Yes. So, we see here the very first sight. It's a very interesting sight. I quite enjoy it. We are seeing that, like I said earlier, the Brig Lucio that I'm not a huge fan of.
Mm-hmm. But they're running it.
They're running it. We'll see if they make it work.
Five, four, three.
We see two, the Bastion again, one. The Echo again, Mercy. It was about the same. However, we do see the Mazaria, which they're playing at the end of the last map. So we'll see what they come up with here. Both teams are approaching the point. Okay, so it is important to note that Speedless did get hot stamp in an early spot on the point. So they are able to hold this high ground. Behind everybody, making it that way. His two kills traded, but I don't think it's gonna be enough.
Wait. They're focusing the tank. Will they be able to get it? No. But Lucio is still on the point. We have Lucio Soldier.
Still here with the soldier, and we did capture the point. So the more time we stall here, the more percent we get. Lucio has beat Lucio. Really use it to counteract him.
Oh, that's a mercy.
That's big. That's all off that.
You cannot escape me.
Lucio was however, I will say, I do not think that beat was a bad play. I do think it got them to 68%.
Because they had three more ults coming
they
up.
They have a bunch of ults. Four. They did switch the soldiers. They don't really have
three. They got three coming up right now.
But this is big, and we forced out one of their biggest ults, which is that Coalescence. Now, they do have this Grav and Echo ult.
They gotta make sure they keep the soldier alive in order to help focus out.
That's
big.
That grab,
a big grab.
There's no boost for the grab, so that's just first explorers, we didn't spend anything on that, and we do get one more fight here. So
I think we get two more.
It ticks really quickly.
Okay.
So I it's already 70, so you definitely get one fight here. Unless you get insta wiped and like barely touch, I don't even think it's possible. But you're at 80%. It's not even a second.
We got the mercy, but a little bit, and there it is, young. But now Orisa, not Orisa, Echo is forced to duplicate Orisa. That was a big tire. I think
And now
we're getting in preparation to hold this and maybe even hold the ult for the next point.
I was about to say, they might not get a good touch here. Because there's only like 2-3 seconds left to touch.
Honestly, I
Mage in, and where's gonna die? Ooh, good bubble by the Elite. But I don't think it's gonna matter.
There
we
go.
And
the Bastional.
We still have ults to spare. Like this is good for us. We did die at the end of that fight, which means we're staggered a little bit. But they're also staggered. So I like this, and we have beat.
But okay. So
where's the next point? There doesn't tell me.
Flash
point
unlocks in 10 seconds.
We're on this map now, and this is also pretty decent for a building. So this Junkrat will have a lot of little ups and downs. Now, despite all the staggers, both things are back about the same time. The question is going to be, will Lucio hold this beat until grab? And
that's
I think
a great
that they
pick.
Will. They swap off the Mercy for the Spear of Poetry, they do not have a red. They Spear off the
He's been hitting those spears, man,
yeah,
and it just annihilates.
They can use this beat to go aggressive and finish this fight.
I don't think they need to be.
They already did.
Okay.
I think he used it before he processed the fact that he got eaten.
Mm-hmm.
Which massive eat and good beat either way. The beat still secures in that fight. They almost have this Junkrat ult and the rally.
Yeah, if they
on
win
on the other side, they don't have anything.
They win this fight and they have secured point two.
They've completely swapped both their supports. They went back to the Mercy, which means they just wasted a bunch of ult charge, and they went to the bottom off of the Moira. Big
and another great pick onto the Ana. Here we go. That's it.
Mercy dies.
That's just a point. That's
point
two. What do we go to? First 3 points?
That's huge. I will say this Junkrat is making such a big difference in these fights, being able to just lurk around the flames and just has a beautiful timing on it.
Suni Oswego just they have to adapt. I mean, you know, it's game 3, you know. You played this Junkrat twice and two different maps.
Off the Zarya. They've conceded that pitch. That was their one Teresa fight. They don't have ult. They only have one ult going in. They'll have Bastion. The Bastion ult hasn't gotten a lot of value as of right now.
Adaptive circuits engage.
Alright, here we go. Trying to push in. Echo just moving in and harassing. Really, really big. And then we now have the visor coming in, but Orisa just bullying.
Yeah, definitely the echo.
Yeah.
They lose that fight. That's a fight I don't think that they should have lost.
Mm-hmm. It was two great picks coming off in the Junkrat, but I think a little bit of discombobulation from the entire team.
And I think it comes down to the fact they had an Ana and we didn't.
Mm-hmm.
That Ana can provide so much healing at the end of the fight.
I don't know. I think at that point you focus the Ana a little bit, throw a Helix even at her, and fuck.
I just don't
focus
think
the
Delta is Pathfinder into the Reset.
Definitely not. You want to take a squishy, but here we go. Now going into another big fight, and the supports are just stuck in the back and can't really heal.
Ana
forced to use the ult onto Echo, and it's just a clean sweep. It's just a very easy. Chased down by
ult.
Lucio.
They have three ults going into this next fight. We have time. We
have one.
This higher, do nutty things.
But we have to play passive. We have to form ults here. Oh, that's not good. Yeah, no, that's not good. That's not good.
Adaptive circuit engaged. Orisa.
Finds Tiana, but it takes out our healer as well.
We have three.
It's now a 3v2. Oh my lord! Oh my god! Wow, what a fight!
I think it comes down to the fact that we were talking about having an Ana. They don't have the Ana this time. Mm-hmm. The Ana can't sustain them.
No, that was huge. And I think it's coming down to one last fight.
Their tank isn't respawned yet. They're going to have to touch without one of their main sources. And that Ana's going to die.
That's it. And now it's 2-1 going in favor of Sunny Podstamp.
That's huge.
That was, wow. 3-0 sweep. That was a great.
Play of the game.
I don't love this Brig Lucio setup, but the Lucio was getting beats when they needed to. And they were protecting from a lot of different things.
Yeah. And they did swap him out when needed to, and I do like the a little bit of the adaptability that the supports had this game. Definitely a big change.
They're doing a good job.
Yeah, definitely a big change. I do like this. It is 9:29 as of right now. And our friend over here, Adriana, has their next game coming up.
Yes, I have to go actually play now. But it was a pleasure, everybody, and I will definitely be catching you guys at a later date. Tune in on, I know for sure, Thursday is when Neck has their Overwatch games, but I'll let Kenny talk about the rest of it.
Gonna leave the stream going through for a quick second and just pop in and out periodically.
objective unlocks in 30 seconds.
Got a little bit of a interesting comp. It seems like they're trying to go a little bit more, trying to be up in their face a little bit more brawly here. But let's see how that works against with their Bastion, against the, you know, Sweego, Bastion and Echo. I mean, it seems like it's working out very, very well. Taking control of the first push, and just quickly just making work of the enemy team. And now we're going to be starting to slowly push towards the first half waypoint.
Incoming fire detected.
Here. Big, what's her face? Oh, I'm losing my train of thought here. I apologize. I need to put this in a long, long time. But quick work has been made of the backline because of the ult giving out anti heal status effect. Junker, apologize. There it is. But now you see over here, you see the Junkrat now getting ready, getting into position, ready to try to take at least one of the back lines out, which is such a strong position as they continue to push. And now they have made it to halfway, and here comes the Junkrat, getting rid of the back line, one DPS, one healer, making this fight a 5v3. That is such a strong kick. And now we have the Lifeweaver tree coming out as long as with the Ramattra. I don't know about that B drop, but you know what? It helps us secure this half. And now we're going to get around the bend and slowly up onto the bridge. We have Lifeweaver and Junker Queen just slowly making work over here, and Lifeweaver pulling back Junker Queen. right back to the building, and Bob comes out. Going to contest the point over here, but you know, we don't really gotta fight that. And now the Bastion Bolt's coming down, and our Symmetra is going down here, and now making a little bit of a quick work of our Junker Queen. Kinda separated over here. Don't exactly know what is going to happen. Taking care of the Orisa, oh my lord. No, and they just, oh my god. Suni Possum is just relentless right now. They're just taking out backline after backline. And so now we're coming over here into the final push over the bridge. Have some ults up. We're going to have Life Weaver ult again. We have Symmetra ult coming up, and we have Junker Queen ult yet again. But on their side, we have an Ana ult. That's a bad ult. Oh, no value off that Junker Queen ult. But here we go. They're still pushing in, still pushing forward, getting the Life Weaver and the Bastion, and our Life Weaver pops their ult. Here we go, pushing them off the point, slowly making their way towards the final point. Junker Queen is anti'd right now, but is making sure that that Ana is just not healing. And their Orisa is just by themselves, and then Junkrat is just harassing them. Life Weaver has to pull them away. And here we go. Battle oozes by themselves, but they're slowly creeping up. That's a great pull from Life Weaver, and now it's a 4v3 into the final point, and that's it. It's just game. Life Weaver ult coming in hot, but Junkrat just quickly just trying to deal that burst damage onto the tree, just trying to take them out. Honestly, you gotta take out the healers here. You just gotta fight the healers. Orisa ult coming in. And another Junkrat. Oh, that's another huge. Oh, another great stagger by the Junkrat. Oh, he doesn't see the Lucio behind him. But here we go. Slowly making work. And Suni Oswego slowly pushing back, taking out Battle Ooze. And abusing the quick spawn time. And it seems like Suni Oswego is back into this point. That was a great, great first push by Podstamp. Oh my lord. They really abused the fact that not a lot of their characters early on that Suni Oswego had movement abilities. And so they really, really abused the Lucio speed boost, making sure that they were just in their face the whole time. And now we're just going to come into this first, coming back to the start of the round. Now we got some ults here. We got the Echo ult coming out. And the Bastion ult. And the Lucio ult. They're investing so many ults here. But now that all the ults are gone, we just have Life Weaver ult. And then it's going to help sustain them. Ooh, not really, though. Tree is immediately taken down. And now their Life Weaver ult pulled out. Symmetra ult is also going down. They're trying to fight around this barrier here. Not really dealing too much damage. This Life Weaver tree is very, very strong. Not being able to take out. Get taken out. Our Junkrat goes down. And that is an easy sweep for Suni Oswego as they are getting ready to push forward onto this next point. What I want to see here, okay, we got a switch coming out from the who were they playing? They're playing the Symmetra. So now we have a Sojourn coming out, hopefully to try to contest this Echo a little bit here, help out the Junkrat a little bit. He can hold his own, but now we do have a little bit of support here from a hit scan, trying to take them out, take out the Life Weaver. Wow, just annihilating the Life Weaver, and now abusing his platform. Oh no, this is not good. That's a great satchel to get out of there, and now they're taking the point, having to take the Junker Queen ult. And takes out our Junkrat, but we are easily able to get back onto the point and start pushing. Echo is forced to just fight for her life as we slowly start to creep back to where we were. Coming into another big fight here, kind of a 5v3 over here, and just a quick kill onto the Life Weaver. And quick work is being made of the Junkrat, the Bastion. And it looks like they may be getting back onto the bridge before another fight is getting underway a little bit. Orisa's forced to back up a little bit and pulled in by the jungler team. Oh, this is gonna be a oh no, that's a huge spear. Huge spear and a huge tire from Junkrat. Oh, beat drop was a little bit too late from SUNY Oswego. But now we're kind of working up our way over here onto the final point. Yet again, Lifeweaver Tree coming out. Echo is just by themselves, kind of just in the back line. And so Orisa is down, but now they have the Junker Queen duplicate out. If they could just hold out here, this is just game for some pod stamp. Quick respawn time coming out from SUNY Oswego and a beat drop from SUNY Potsdam. And they're pushed back. Forced out the Lifeweaver ult. Very, very good force. Now they're just coming in with three ults as opposed. I mean, it's good that they wasted the ult, you know, that's great. That's phenomenal, but you know, kind of with us, we're kind of a little bit behind on ult. I think these next couple fights have to be used to farm the ult and just get kills. It's 15 seconds. They have to be able to push all the way up, basically up to the last point. So SUNY Oswego is making their push. This is great. I love the passiveness. I love the pacifist. That's a huge anti. That's a huge anti, and it does not matter if you drop the beat. It does not matter, and that's a clean sweep from Podstam. And they're able to hold the robot right in the middle, as they're easily able to take out the rest of SUNY Oswego. And it is just futile. It's just futile. And SUNY Podstam has taken map 4. And I think they just took the game from yes, it is game. SUNY Potsdam has won 3-1 against SUNY Oswego on their first game. Congratulations. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. You know, it was fun to watch, fun to commentate. You know, there were great games. Very, very nice work from both teams. Very, very solid win for SUNY Potsdam. So again, congratulations. 3-1 SUNY Potsdam victory over SUNY Oswego. Hopefully we'll be back next week. Either for Valorant or for Overwatch. I don't know who exactly we're going to be streaming next, but it's one of those two games, or even Guilty Gear. So we'll catch you back next week. Tomorrow, I don't think we have any games streamed as of yet, so just stay tuned. We'll keep you guys updated. Thank you so much for stopping by, guys. Have a good night.